The purpose of this video is to show you how to use remote access or give control in Zoom. If you're looking for how to do this in Microsoft Teams, see my other video in the playlist. I'll link it in the description box. We are using Zoom right now. If you have other questions about how to use Zoom, see some of my Zoom tutorials in my playlist. All right, so I am in a Zoom meeting right now. As I normally do, I'm meeting with myself on another computer so I can show you guys both sides. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna screen share. So again, if you have questions about Zoom, I'm gonna go through this pretty quickly and really just focus on remote access. But if you need to see how to screen share or how to do other things, again, just visit the other videos and then come on back. So I'm gonna share the entire desktop. This is what I have found to work best for remote access. I'm gonna go ahead and share it. So now, if you look, my student can see my entire desktop. So this is gonna be how you would use remote access. You have to screen share first. What's great about Zoom is while you're screen sharing, you can actually keep an eye on your students. So that's my student right there, and I can see them, I can see what they're doing, and vice versa, my student can see me. So this is really great to keep this accessible for students with hearing loss, or students who sign, or students who need to read lips, or any other reason that you would need to see their face and vice versa. So we're on the Zoom app. All right, so now I am screen sharing. I'm gonna pull up my boom cards. I'm gonna use boom cards as an example because I could see this being something people would want to use remote access for. And I'm sharing the boom cards. I'm gonna click on the boom card I want. And now at the top, if you notice, there's a bar up here where I'm screen sharing. It says you are screen sharing, stop share. It gives you all these options. I want the student to be able to click on the answer because right now, if a student clicks on an answer, I can't see anything. But if I give them access, I can see what they're clicking on. So this is going to make my lesson a lot more interactive. And you can actually have them do more than just boom cards. They could do a Word document with you. You can play games. So it's really giving them total control to manipulate the mouse on your computer. So again, I'm gonna go up to that bar at the top. And if I hover over the green bar, this comes up. Where it says remote control, I'm gonna click on that and it's gonna ask me to give them control. So I'm gonna click on the user. And now they do have control. I've noticed with Zoom, it takes a couple minutes or a little time for it to sync up. So as you can see, I'm moving the mouse. It's not working yet. The student must click the keypad and then the control should kick in. So as you can see right now, the student is actually moving the mouse. Things are not highlighting yet though. If the student clicks again, now it's highlighting. So now the student is able to click on the answers. This is the concept of remote access, giving the student control. So if I ask the student, find the triangle, the student can click on the triangle and I would know. Or if I said, find the circle, the student could click on the circle and I can see what they clicked on. The student even has the control to type on the computer. So for example, if the student wanted to go to another website, which obviously we probably wouldn't do during a live session, but I want to demonstrate the range of control they have. The student could click in here and they could type in something. So I just typed a letter. And if you look on my screen, that's what came up. So this is basically remote access or remote control. So to reiterate, give me 1 second. We shared something with them. They're seeing it, but they can't click on it yet. So we went up to the top, we hovered, this bar came up, we clicked remote control, we chose the participant we're giving control to. And now if the participant clicks, they can start clicking on the answers. So find the star, they can click it. So this is how you would do remote access or give control on Zoom. I hope it was helpful. It will definitely make your live sessions a lot more interactive. Let me know if there's anything else you want to see. I'm definitely here to help you guys.